In our web development journey, we rely on various colors to define the visual identity of our websites. However, managing these colors across different elements and ensuring consistency can often be challenging. Besides CSS custom properties, there's another indispensable yet lesser-known tool specifically tailored for handling colors. In this brief video, we will familiarize ourselves with the current color keyword. But first, make sure to hit the subscribe button and ring the notification bell to stay updated on our front-end development tutorials. Let's dive in. Today, we are starting with a simple page featuring a page title and some social profile links. Our CSS file is prepped with foundational styles for the page. Following that, the parent div is set as a flex container, and we have applied some presentational styles to the anchor tags. Here's what our page looks like. Now let's say we want to ensure that the border color of the links matches their text color. One approach would be to repeat color values using the color and border properties. However, this could become cumbersome, especially if we plan to update the theme in the future, and it might introduce the possibility of unintentional errors. Alternatively, we can leverage custom properties to store color values and use them as needed. But beyond that, there's another elegant solution: the current color keyword. This keyword allows us to effortlessly maintain consistent colors within elements. Let's explore how we can utilize it to enhance our workflow. The current color keyword functions like a variable, representing the current value of the color property on the element. What's great is that the cascading nature of CSS still applies. So if there's no explicitly defined color property on an element, the cascade will determine the value of current color. Consider this example. We are setting the border color to be similar to the color property of the anchor tag. It means that if any changes are made to the color property, the border color will automatically reflect those changes. And even if we remove the color property, CSS will fetch the color from its ancestors through the cascading effect. This ensures consistency and saves us from manually updating colors in multiple places. Interestingly, in this example, defining a border color is unnecessary since it defaults to current color. This behavior extends to several other properties, including box shadow, outline color, and text decoration color. Let's put this to the test by adding an outline to the link. Notice how the outline and border colors change dynamically without specifying their color values. Now, you might wonder, if the cascade effect handles color inheritance automatically, what's the use of the current color keyword? While the cascade effect manages color inheritance for certain properties, the current color keyword serves a unique purpose. It allows us to use the color value on properties that don't receive it by default. Imagine we want to enhance our design by adding the before pseudo element to our social links. This pseudo element is positioned absolutely behind its parent element, and the width and height are set to 100%. Since the pseudo element doesn't have any color property defined, and the background color doesn't automatically inherit the color value, we can leverage the current color keyword to simplify the process of applying unique colors to each link. For example, we can set the YouTube link as red, Twitter as black, and Facebook as blue, aligning with their respective brands. What's even better is that we don't need to update the before pseudo element separately for each link. The current color keyword handles this dynamically. Considering we now have full-blown CSS variables, we may not find ourselves reaching for current color from our bag of tricks very often. However, it's reassuring to know that it's there if the need arises. In conclusion, current color is a cool yet often overlooked keyword in CSS. It serves as a handy color variable for specific use cases, offering a simple and effective way to maintain consistency and flexibility in our design. If you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more exciting tips and tricks. Thanks for tuning in, and see you next time.